Well, let's define a great safety and mission assurance officer. If Tommy Holloway is a program manager and I'm matrixed to be his safety guy in charge of my safety team, how do I want him to look at me and my team? Here it is, okay? Technically credible, imbued with engineering curiosity. They're not just in there taking notes. Courageous, they'll speak up. They'll raise the BS flag when it's time, but not more than that, okay? And that's more than courage, that's smarts and a few other things about intelligence and common sense and so on. High integrity, solid knowledge of your requirements and their rationale, Don't just go on there and say, you can't do this, requirement says no, and then go back to your cubicle. Good communication skills, both verbal and written. You know, if you got a problem with something and you can't communicate, you're not helpful. I don't think these are unique to SMA, by the way, but they certainly do apply to our team. Experienced in an applicable field. Okay. Now, you can have people that are not, but you better have some that are. I'm not talking about one person fills all these. The team does this. Humble, yet engaged. Persistent, yet pragmatic. You know, you stick to your guns. If you got a strong opinion on something, and you think it's the right thing to do, you may want to even take it back. And when you do, you go to the program manager and say, you know, we're having this argument, and I'm just not able to get it across, but you haven't gotten across to me yet either. I'm going to get some reinforcements and go back and get some and have the discussion. Okay? But when it's laid out and you find out, well, I guess I was wrong. There's another mitigator here that enters the picture, and I hadn't even thought of that. Press on. You know, just because I said it was wrong yesterday, I got to keep to my, no. Be pragmatic. We got a program to run here. It's either a problem or not, and when it's not, then we press on. Energetic and creative. This is the yes if. Now, this one ties up here. No because person knows their requirements. A yes if person knows the requirements, the safety requirements, the technical requirements, and they also know why they're there, when they apply, when they don't. What are alternatives? What are not? That's the depth of their knowledge. That's what we need from them. Because then it can be yes if. The first step of yes if is no because. And every now and then you just have to stop something and, you know, and go a different direction. But there are times when you come up against a requirement and it could stop you. Because you can't move forward without a waiver to this requirement. When we get into that mode, our team has to be yes if kind of people. We have to go back and do our homework, find out why does that requirement say what it does, what are the alternatives, what's something that's the equivalent safety we could entertain here. Now the safety team can't do all that. In fact, most of that is going to be done by the engineering and ops folks that are involved. We're pretty much outnumbered as a team, but they have to be in that mode. Hey guys, let's think about something else. Let me go back and get some help here. Or I know the guy that wrote this, you know, let's go talk to him. Facilitate it if you can't actually do it. And then you got to have some thick skin and a sense of humor because, again, you know, safety guys are to engineers as the Marines are to the Navy. And I've been in both places, so I can say that. It's fun to make fun of them. It's fun to say how you don't really need them. But we need to get in a mode where you actually do need them. And they come in handy once in a while, okay? So that's what I tell my folks.